Coral reefs don't occupy much of the surface of the earth, but they are the Amazon rainforests of the sea. They have the highest known biodiversity of both vertebrates, say fish, and invertebrates.
It's just an explosion of color. It's so alive, so vibrant.
It looks like an artist took their palette and tossed it into the water.
We've been here studying coral reef ecology and conservation in the Republic of Palau.
It's a course focused on how science and policy interact. We give the students a chance actually to do original research. It's an intro to how we do a lot of this kind of interdisciplinary oceanography.
Palau's this amazing nation in the far western Pacific, right? It's about 800 miles east of the Philippines. It's tropical, it's very warm, very stable climate year-round. Many hundreds of islands, it's in a high rainfall belt, so the islands are incredibly lush. We're surrounded by jungles here. It's a jungle above the water, but also a jungle below the water. The coral reefs here are absolutely spectacular.
This area has one of the highest biodiversities of any place in the world, and the coral reefs here have been remarkably well preserved from recent events such as bleaching events, which have been really catastrophic for corals in the Caribbean and in other areas around the world.
Here we're interested in what makes coral reefs tick, how do coral reefs respond to changes that are introduced by human activities, and what might be done to reduce or mitigate, maybe minimize impacts on reefs. And you can't really do that without understanding what's happening today on these coral reefs. One of our mottos is in the water every day. They take on projects that can be accomplished in a short period of time, say a week to 10 days of field work.
Some projects are a lot more technical, whereas some are more observation-based. We have students who are doing ecological transects on the reef, using transect tapes to describe the environment within each quadrat or count different things like coral cover, dead coral cover. Then we have instrumentation for hydrodynamics and some of the physics. We brought instruments to measure currents, instruments to measure pressure gradients, pH of the water, the concentration of carbon dioxide.
And when we put all of this together, as a number of the students are doing, the physics plus the chemistry, it's letting us learn things about reefs that, in some cases, nobody ever knew before.
They all tie back to Palau as a system, of which the coral reefs are a major role in providing services for the amazing plants and animals that live here, but also the people, in terms of breaking storm waves, easing the impact of typhoons, providing food for the local population.
It's a unique place almost in terms of interest and willingness to do things to manage the ocean, a place where the ocean and people really connect.
Conservation has been part of Palauan culture for several hundred years, and the rest of the world is kind of just catching up to the care and consideration that they show for the marine environment.
Once I was in the water and fully immersed in the experience, and I think even more importantly, have the one-on-one conversations with the people here, I've gathered a better understanding of the human ecosystem interactions, and that there's really no simple way of saving the reefs without also finding a way to support the people.
A huge part of Palau's economy and also their culture is rooted in coral reefs, and so it's a mix of economic importance, cultural importance, and also just, you know, the beauty of the biodiversity for all of us to appreciate and experience.
Some of the places the students are working is, in a way, the world of the future, the ocean of the future, where the water today has chemical and thermal conditions like we expect many other reefs to experience after 100 years of global change.
Coral reefs are in danger around the world with bleaching, with human impact, pollution. So the more we know about how that's affecting them, the more of a difference we can make.
I'm hoping that it's not a race now to see things before they're gone, but instead to find out why some areas are still thriving and make sure that they continue to do so in the future.
For more, please visit us at stanford.edu.